Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video, we will practice Microsoft Power BI PL 300 exam question related to simplifying Power BI model by removing complex measures which contains related and related table DAX functions. And the question is, you have a data model that contains many complex DAX expressions. The expressions contain frequent references to the related and related table functions. You need to recommend a solution to minimize the use of related and related table functions. What should you recommend? And under options, the first option is split the model into multiple models. By splitting the model, we will end up in multiple reports. So this will increase the complexity instead of simplifying the model. So this option will not work. Then option B is hide unused columns in the model. So by hiding unused columns, we can simplify the model and it will look nice and clean, but still it will not remove the complex measures where we have used related and related table DAX functions. So this option also we can ignore. Option C is merge tables by using Power Query. By merging tables, we can simplify the model as we will have less number of tables in the model. So we can try this option in Power BI Desktop. And option D is transpose. We use transpose usually for reshaping the data, but here the given case is to remove the complex measures from the model. So this option we can ignore. And let's try option C in Power BI Desktop. So over here in Power BI Desktop, we can see we have three tables. Product, where we have list of all the products. Then we have product subcategory. Under that, we have list of product subcategories. Then in third table, we have list of orders. Now let's try to add complex measures using related and related table function. So over here, let's assume we want to add one column in dim product table, where we will have total order value for product. So for that, let's add one column and we want to name it as the product order value. And the value will come from fact order table. So let's select SUMX. It should come from related table, that is fact order, and it should be sum of the order value. So now let's try to add one more column, and in that column we want to achieve the product category. So for that, let's add one more column and let's name it as the product subcategory. And this should come from product subcategory table. Now we are getting product subcategory order value against the product. Now over here we can see in dim product, we have created two calculated columns and where we have used a related and related table DAX functions. So now to avoid this, we can achieve this using the merge tables. So now let's merge these tables and we will try to achieve the same layout from merged table. So for that, let's go to the transform editor. And over here we want to merge all these three tables. For that, let's first select fact order and we want to merge it with the product. So for that, let's select on the merge and we want to merge dim product, and the common key is the product ID. And from this table, we want product and product subcategory ID, and we can ignore product ID as we already have this field available in fact order. And let's click on OK. Now we have achieved both the columns. Now let's merge this table with subcategory. So for that, let's click on the merge as a new. And this time we want to merge it with subcategory. And between these two tables, now we have product subcategory ID as the common key. And let's click on the OK. Now from this table, we just want product subcategory name. And now let's click on the OK. Now let's try to achieve the same details from this merge table. So let's click on the apply. Now over here we have merge table. So now let's plot one matrix using this table. And under this we need product ID. Then we need product subcategory. Then we need value. and let's add product as well. Now let's make this layout as the minimal for better view. And now over here we can validate the data, and here we can see for product jean, subcategory is bottom wear and total order value is the 380 million. Now let's verify same in the earlier expression, and here we can see for jeans we are getting bottom wear subcategory and we are getting 380 million as a order value. So in this way we are able to achieve the same data by merging the table. Now developers or user will have only one table to develop this report, that is merge one, and all the rest of the tables we can hide from the model. So this will simplify the model by ignoring all the calculated complex measures and having just one table in the model. So now let's go back to our question, and here option C, merge tables by using Power Query, is the correct answer.